Hello everyone and welcome. With the release of version 2.11 and the introduction of Heroic Grails, players can now plus 10 limited units. With that in mind, I've decided to create a short video guide for, well, all of them at plus 10. In part 1, we're talking about the free units added through Tempest Trials, up through the end of book 2. First, we have, in my opinion, the biggest winner of the entire update. Arden is nothing short of a monster. When you survey the entire roster, including Gen 2 premium units, Arden has one of the most min-maxed stat allocations in the entire game. Arden is slow and has awful res, but who the hell cares? He can toss out gigantic specials and takes an absurd amount of physical punishment. Arden is only held back by the popularity of dragons and armor slayers in the general metagame, but everything else is no sweat. Next up, we have the Black Knight. If Arden is the most exciting prospect, then Black Knight is the most obvious. At plus 10, the Black Knight is functionally equivalent to Zelgius in all regards, save for score. He hits fast, hits hard, and can go over the top thanks to Black Luna. Just like Zelgius, Black Knight wants Breath, Bold, and QR to fully come into his own. However, you can also experiment with crazy builds too. Third, we have Kanas. Despite his popularity as a character, Kanas's stats and skills don't do him any favors. Still, at plus 10, Kanas can contribute. He has the res to ploy, the damage to be relevant, and is bulkier than he first appears. I wouldn't recommend that you invest in Kanas, but you have the option if you want to. Likewise, Clive is underwhelming, even at plus 10. He faces stiff competition from units like Lucas, and even within the Cavalier category, he has to deal with Silas at 4 star. Clive has good art, but a very lackluster base kit and no access to the skills which really make enemy phase walls good. As our first and only 175 BST free unit, Eliwood is going to be a popular choice for score alone. He doesn't wall very well, at least not as well as you'd expect for a 175 armor, but with 42 attack and 36 speed, he's a diverse and potent threat. Eflin has a lot of physical defense for a healer, but suffers from a critical flaw. She isn't Veronica. If you want a plus 10 cavalry healer for cheap, I'd recommend Clarine, Priscilla, and Nana. It's sad to say, but with how slow Grail acquisition appears to be, I just don't think Eflin is worth it. Finn rides the same line. He has the stats of a mixed phase bruiser, but I feel like he's too slow to excel. Compared to Clive, Finn is almost a straight upgrade, but just like Clive, he faces competition from too many common lance units, so I don't see him becoming a popular plus 10 choice. The same is sadly true for Jerome. Jerome has good bulk, a lot of attack, and salvageable speed, but Cherche is 3 star, can be specialized with IVs, and performs just as well, if not better. Groom Marth, on the other hand, gets a pass for his novelty. Green Cavalier is a very thin category, and I can see some people looking at Marth's speed and giving him a chance. Personally though, I'd recommend Walhart if you want a limited Cavalier. Halloween Dorcas crashes in with 45 attack, on par with some of the premium Gen 2 armors. If that doesn't excite you, then I don't know what will. With Grails, Halloween Dorcas might as well be the free version of Winter Crom. Crom does have better stat allocation overall, but Dorcas beats him on base kit and, let's face it, good looks. Moving on, we have two of the most anticipated mergeable Tempest Trials units, Joshua and Marissa. Of the two, Joshua has less physical bulk and fares better against mages and dragons. Marissa is more of a bruiser. She reaches impressive levels of physical bulk and deals most of her damage through specials. These two units have wanted to scale for ages. They have the stats at plus 0 to do good work, and now, with Grails, they can finally grow into that role. Masked Marth is Lucina. At plus 10, Lucina is good, so Masked Marth is good too. I expect a lot of people will finish this one because it'll be easy, and to be honest, I don't blame you. Falchion is amazing right now, and Marth is likely to be a safe, long-term investment. New Year's Corrin is probably the weirdest unit on this list. Is he bad? No. Is he good? Well, maybe. He's a close counter archer and performs well if you allow him to throw out Bonfire. Is that worth all your grails? Maybe. It's definitely not meta, but it sure looks like a lot of fun. Finally, we have Tobin, or now that he can be merged, Red Donnell. With his high BST and well-rounded stats, Tobin is a great plus 10 candidate. Fully merged, he has 50 HP, 35 attack, 31 speed, 37 defense, and 30 res. None of that is pointed in any particular direction, but that's kind of a good thing. Tobin is a blank canvas. He's a unit that can be pushed in any direction and will do almost any job. To sum things up, I think Arden, Black Knight, and Elliewood are by far the strongest Tempest Trials units. Halloween Dorcas brings up a close fourth. After that, I'd probably focus on Masked Marth, Joshua, Marissa, or Tobin, depending on your preference. These units are decent investments, and any of them will serve you well for the long term. The other Tempest Trials units are strong in their own way, but they might just take too much effort to be worth it. Thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please consider leaving a like or subscribing. You can find me on Twitter, @DireThunderYT, so feel free to send me cool stuff or just drop by to say hello. As always, I hope to see you next time. Take care.